Ebony's letter written by Howard Anthony Glover. Okay, August 23rd, 2018 over rise a house in a middle-class Atlanta neighborhood. Camera pans in a room as we see a young black woman wrapped up in silk, white sheets, her Brazilian sew-in that she had put in the night before raped over both pillows, and she snoring alarm goes off at 6:45 a.m. She will opens her eyes, camera cuts to her stretching her arms, she arises wearing white shorts and a white tank top. She cuts on the television and the newscaster says, "Good morning, Atlanta." She looks at the television through vanity mirror as she get in shower Hitchcock camera motion as a shower pours. The phone cell phone rings. Ebony White, hello. Hello, got you. I can't get to my phone, but do what you want. Isn't that the point? Scene change. It's a hectic work atmosphere as telephones are ringing, fax machines are going off. There is a young attractive man at a desk with a nameplate that says James Carr. As he sit with his feet up on the desk, and he's looking at a 4-carat diamond ring, as he's look at it he look defeated. James minus E. Baby, what's going on? I just hope I didn't. I don't wanna put pressure on you, I need you E. I wanna give you the life that you deserve. Just tell me. Yes or no? E. I love you. Back to shower. As the message plays. She has her hair under the water halfway in the bonnet, just laying still as if she's posing for the cover of Vogue. Camera cuts to her hands and you see red French tip nails. Turning the cold and hot faucets to the opposite sides. But the water at once to stop, the water stops at once with three drips coming out. As Ebony steps out the shower, she grab gray tile wops around her chest, then she wipes off the fog from the mirror. She stands there for 15 seconds looking deep into her eyes. She snatches the bonnet off, take both hands and wring out the side of her hair that was damp. She picks up her Beverly irons and she begins to dry her hair out, and she does that, the door scratches and her black and white kitten comes in and starts rubbing against her feet. She looks down and begins to show a slight smile. Ebony equals hey bodice, I have to take you to the vet today. Today is the day that's going to change the rest of your life, but you'll be a happier cat as you get older, you'll understand. Camera cuts to a iron, a shirt being put over a woman's chest area, hot coffee being poured. An hour and 45 minutes has passed. Ebony has on her clothes, made breakfast, and is on her way out the door, has a hot cup of coffee on her way out. She walks past her father's memorial that she had for photos of them throughout her life, and his obituary. She stands at the doors for 2 minutes to get herself together. She puts her key at the door, and before she walks out she remember she has one thing to do, and that's the call the person who never she really doesn't want to talk to is Ebony Key about the terms. They open the door, she put patches in his cage and calls. Scene change. Vicky White is a successful attorney in Atlanta. She passed the bar the first time she took it. She made partner by 30 years of age. She raised the only child that she has, which is Ebony, and her husband who passed away 3 years prior. She's a very determined woman and she loves her daughter and her career. We're just not sure which one she puts first. Vicky phone rings. Vicky equals, happy birthday Eb, how are you doing? You never call your mother, I've been worried sick, Leo and I just been worried throughout our minds. You never call us. Ebony equals mom, I told you over and over again. I've been working, James been working, we haven't had much time together, and honestly I haven't had a lot of time for myself with this new promotion that I have. Vicky equals congratulations. Sweetheart, on your promotion, it's a shame you've had it for 2 months, and that's the last time I spoke to you. I haven't even had a chance to throw you a party or anything. See how you treat your mother? It's really not fair, Ebony, I tell you it's really not fair. It breaks my heart. As Ebony tries to say something, Vicky quickly says something that Ebony can remember hearing her whole life. Vicky in a rush to talk over Ebony. Vicky equals baby, sorry mommy got to go. My client's here. Ebony shows a bit of sadness for 2 seconds, then she becomes more irritating, rolling her eyes and sucking her teeth, and she closes eyes. She takes a deep breath and in the deep breath out and she says, Ebony equals mom, look, I've been hearing this for 36 years and at the end of the day, it is what it is. I need you to do me one favor. Could you please take patches for me this weekend? Vicky equals, okay, baby. I'll do it only on one condition. You got to promise me that you'll come see me when you get back from this trip this weekend. Ebony looks up towards the ceiling and she says, saying, Ebony equals, okay, mom, I love you. Vicky equals, I love you too, and Ebony, baby, it's your birthday. Enjoy it. It's a warm Atlanta day. The temperature is 73 degrees Fahrenheit. It's very sunny. The sky blue and with the giant white cloud. As she walked out of her townhouse, she looks up at the sky. Takes a deep breath. She takes a moment to think and she decides that she's going to walk to work today. The television station is only 2 miles down from her house. She could be there in 20 minutes or so. She decided to leave her car keys and walk, and she walks. She sees then people. She see everyday Mr. and Mrs. Godfrey. Mike, the guy that works in the deli shop. Ebony and Mike been friends for well over 15 years. They went to high school together. And whenever she had trouble, he was there to help. He was always there her who the right path, and whenever she need help, she would go to hell or used to. Ebony gets 4 doors down from her townhouse. She hears a male voice in a distance, calling her, and 3 seconds passes. Each time, he calls until the sound gets closer. Ebony turns around and she sees her good friend Mike. Mike equals goddamn it girl, slow the hell down. Why are you walking so fast to station? You're not on till noon, what's the rush? That crummy ass station ain't going nowhere without their best new news anchor. Ebony look up at the sky and close her eyes and shakes her head. Asterisk, 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 what are you doing here? I thought you were in Philly at the restaurant convention. Why aren't you there? Mike equals well damn best friend, I'm happy to see you as well. I didn't go to the restaurant convention. He looks down to the ground because I couldn't afford it. He chuckles, lately I had to help my mom out with the bills this month, you know how that is. Or maybe you don't. They both look annoyed with each other, but they love each other, so they begin to walk and talk, and Ebony grips Mike by his arm tight and asks him. Ebony equals why the fasterisk asterisk asterisk didn't you tell me if you needed the money? Mike equals I wasn't going to ask you for anything else. It's about time I do something for myself. You've done enough when your dad passed away 3 years ago. You made sure me and my mom and my whole family ate. I can't ask you for anything else, I just can't. Ebony comes to a complete stop in, and 1/2 of a second later Mike does as well. She demands that he listen to every word that she says. Ebony equals I'm going to ask you a question. And please don't give me some dumbest answer. Ebony begins to breathe slow and she asks is. Ebony equals how much do you need to get to Philly? And see get in their competition and make the sandwich that I know you can. Make you probably don't know you can make it. I know you can. I'm not always going to be around to push you. You had to learn how to push yourself. So I'm going to ask your fasterisk asterisk 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 ass again. How much does it cost to go? Mike is dazed and confused. Mike equals black GRL. Stop. Ebony equals looks at her watch. It says asterisk asterisk asterisk. I got to hurry up and make it to work. She looks at Mike as she begins to run, and she tells him he needs to take his dummies home and pack his bags. Cuz he's going to be on the flight to Philly by 7, and he needs to not worry about expenses for a hotel and everything, because she reminds him she has his back. Ebony continues to walk. Scene change. Ebony arrives at the studio, is frantic. You have Wiley Jones, the senior male anchor, having it out with the executive producer, aka Brandon Laws. As Ebony gets closer and closer to walk through the doors of the set, she hears the shouting between the two. She overhears a pissing match about a story that the executive producer wants done. Brandon Laws, but the senior anchor doesn't want it done. At this point, Ebony is clueless and she's walking into her office, and she's greeted by her assistant Stacy Carradine. Stacy equals good morning Ms. White, how are you today? As she hands Ebony here a tenny for the day. 1, you have a meeting with city councilor. 2, meeting on staff budget. 3, you have a meeting with the police coroner. As he said it, Ebony faced Spock 1,000 words. Slowly she oot. Ebony equals that scum. Stacy, who looked shocked but yet interested. Stacy equals Ms. White. She's in deep pause Atesian. Stacy equals are you? Ebony equals I just don't believe it. I told him over and over that I couldn't do this fasterisk asterisk 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 story, but what am I going to do? I'm just going to do it. Stacy equals Ms. White, I'm going to go and get your notes ready. I think you should get ready to go to make up your own less than 2 hours, and I just want you to know that I admire you. I congratulate you getting where you are. I knew you put in a lot of hard work for it. Stacy. Ebony equals Stacy, these last 4 of 5 years have just been. The screen goes blank. Wally Jones' voice. Wally Jones equals well, today was mostly a warm day, and before we go off the air, we want to wish our sister, and she's like a daughter to me more. I love you, Ebony White, for the last 6 months. She has been doing the greatest job, and we just want to congratulate. Scene change. Newsroom, balloons, cake, people dancing to Drake, God's plan. Stacy, Ebony, Wiley, or at the table that was made special for Stacy that has birthday cake, fried chicken, baked chicken, fried shrimp, caviar, turkey. They were having a conversation how to make the broadcast better. Wally talking with his mouth full of food as he's hammering down on his plate, he says to Ebony. Wally Jones equals Miss White, do you know, when I started at the station, I was the first African-American male. There was an anchor, I just want you to know, he looked over at Stacy. YouTube, Stacy, the hardest thing in this world is to live in it. There's nothing that you go through in life that you can come back from. And I want you both to live your best life. This business can be cruel and it can be nasty, but it's our job to make sure people know the truth and maybe not always be the best answer, because sometimes the pain, sometimes the cure is worse than the actual disease. Ebony equals looks at Wiley with warmest look. Stacy equals I told you the same thing earlier, as she whispers in Ebony's ear. 2 hours passed, it is now 7:45 in the evening, the sun is beginning set. Stacy and Ebony begin to walk down the hall to exit the station. Stacy takes 4 steps forward, turns around and looks and smiles at Ebony. Stacy equals are you going to be okay? I'm worried about you, I'm not going to lie about that. Let me give you a lift home. Ebony equals that's enough for the day. Stacy, you can clock out and go home. Ebony walked back towards the office and she tells Stacy, she's doing an excellent job and to keep up the good work. You never know when I'll be watching you. Stacy equals I'll keep that in mind, Miss White. Ebony equals I'm gonna tell you one last time, call me Ebony. Ebony walks towards the elevator to go from the parking lot to the lobby, and she is the elevator doors open. She sees Brandon Loss, her ball's executive producer, walking to his car. As he puts his key in the car door, she yells his name in fury and anger. Ebony equals how could you? I told you that I could not do that. Asterisk story. I didn't want to have no parts of it, and yet what did you do? You backstab me. You and I had an agreement. Brandon equals Ebony. That's the biz, kid. You know, in this business, those are the stories that get you where you want to be. You wanted this position, God knows you did anything to get it. Shut your mouth, sit back and just enjoy what you work so hard for. Many of other people will bless to be in your position, and yet you want to sit and asterisk about it. Ebony exiting building, onto the street, she takes the long way home. She walks, and as she walks, she begins to smile and chair and do the thing, walking past places that she had noticed for a long time. She envisioned memories of her and her dad at the park, her prom by her side, when she thought she wasn't able to get into this college she wanted to get into. Then as she walked by, she see Mr. and Mrs. Godfrey sitting on the steps. Ms. Godfrey equals Ebony, get over here. Ebony equals yes, Mrs. G, how are you? Ms. Godfrey, I just want you to know that we're all so very proud of you. I remember you when you were a baby and how many you and your dad used to pick you up and take you to the store, and I used to run around here playing with your toys. I just want you to know that we really love you. Me and Mr. G. Ebony looks down at Mrs. G. Ebony equals, I just want to say thank you, as she taking Mrs. G's hand for being the mother that I've never had. Ebony equals walks 2 blocks down and gets to her townhouse. She puts the key in the door and she sees that her mother Vicky has picked up patches. Like she asks, she sits down on the step and she hails Mike.
The ending.
Mike equals, what's up, Matt, what's up, and thank you so much. I just landed in Philly. I'm running a little bit behind, but I'm about to jump in the cab. What's up, everything okay, what's going on? Ebony equals, remember when we were little and we used to go to Busch Gardens every summer, and how I was always scared to get on the roller coasters, and you always grabbed me by the hand and told me everything was going to be all right and we'll ride. And I was so afraid. I just want to say thank you for that, Mike. Mike equals, are you up, bitch? You not rolling, are you? Ebony equals, no, I'm not, I'm just, you know, thank you for everything. All right, that's a asterisk beeping in, so make sure I know you're going to win that competition, and I'm going to be watching you. Okay, you better win, see you later, bye. Ebony's which is the line in his James on the other end, an angered frenzy. Ebony equals, what I told you, I was done. James equals look at me, I'm not playing games with you, you belong with me, and that's just how it's going to be. I told you I'm not none of these other asterisk 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 you be faster as asterisk 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 with. I have money, I can do what I want to whoever I want to do it with. You're mine, you're going to have my baby. Ebony throws her cell phone down on the car with it breaking. Is James still talking? She gets up, blow Mrs. Godfrey a kiss. She goes down, goes in the house. She comes from the radio and plays Nat King Cole and Natalie Cole. Unforgettable camera shows the house as it backs up and everything is quiet. And then you hear a gunshot. Black screen. The end.
She killed herself.
But it's kind of serious. What you take off?